Are you a beginner with Make and want to learn how to build automation with Make yourself? Then keep watching the series and I will show you how you can build your first scenarios and build automations at ease. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of TechFlow.ai and we love automation. In this second video of the series of Make for Beginners tutorials 2022, I will show you what the concept of scenarios and operations is and how you can work with triggers and modules and what they actually mean. All right, first, let's get into scenarios. What is a scenario? This is a scenario. It's basically one process that you can automate. It can have multiple modules. So each of these bubbles is called a module. For example, this one over here, this one, this one, this one. And it's basically one single action that happens anywhere on a specific software, like a Google Sheet, Shopify. It can be a Zoom or whatever. So one specific action that happens somewhere is called a module. And at the very beginning of the scenario, there's always a trigger. A trigger means how does this automation start? When does it start? When do we want it to start? In this case, it's called a webhook. We will get to that later, but in that case, it's a webhook, but you can define anything here. Let's create our first scenario by just going into your scenarios at the left side and then click on create a new scenario. You can also do this from the dashboard, from the main dashboard. And then in the middle, you have this big plus symbol, which shows, okay, you have to select a module first in order to start it. Let's click on that one. And now you see a long, long list of all the apps that are available that you can integrate. So you have like 1000 plus things available here that you can integrate. The most used are probably Gmail or Google Sheets or Google Drive, and you can use them all. In our case, I want to check a Google Drive folder if there's a new file inside that folder. And if you click on Google Drive, you can see all of these actions that are available. So these are all the things that you can automate on Google Drive within the module. So you can just choose whatever you want, and then it will transform into a module, and then you can do the further settings. For example, watch files in a folder. This is the one that we are going to use now. I click on it, and then the next thing is to create a connection. So you can choose your account if you already have an existing connection, or you can add a new one and you can give it a name. So let's name it Make for Beginners, and then press save. And now you can just log in with your Google account. I will blur this out and create the connection. So Make has the permission to do certain things on your Google Drive account. Now the connection got verified and we have access to the settings actually of this module. So this is our trigger module, the first module inside our scenario, which we will use to trigger our automation. I won't explain the settings in detail now. I will just select one folder and then we can use that one. Okay, so here we are. We choose the folder and then we are watching this folders if there's a new file coming in. And then we can also choose, oops, sorry, I closed it too quickly. We can also choose if we wanna just watch new files or if we wanna watch all files from the past as well since a specific date, or if we just wanna process all of them, or choose manually and you can select one of the files that are already inside that folder. So for now, we just select from now on. This here at the bottom, you have the save, you have scenario settings, you have notes, auto align, where you can just align your modules easily. And then you can also let it explain. Of course, this is just one module. It doesn't make too much sense. And then you can also define the schedule. This is basically how often you want to run the scenario. You can set it at regular intervals, which means it will run every 15 minutes and check if there's a new file. Or you can set it to once if you want to schedule it on a specific date and time. And then you can also say, okay, I want to run it every day at this given time, or days of the week, days of the month, or specified dates. So days of the month would look like this, or specified dates. You can do every February or March and at the 15th, for example, at this time. So this is how you can schedule your scenario when you want the automation to actually run. And then by clicking on the plus symbol right next to it, you can add more modules to your scenario. And then, for example, you can say, okay, I want to move a file folder to, I want to move a file folder to another folder. So I choose the connection again. Sometimes you have to extend the permissions, like in this case, because it's doing more actions now than what you have originally agreed on. So you might have to extend the permissions. Don't worry about that one. This is just like once, and then this action will always work in the future. Now, how this all works and how we set this up, I will show you in the next video. If you like this video and want to learn more about Make and how you can use it for yourself, then please hit this like and subscribe button to get notified about new videos that are coming out about Make, and you will learn more about Make automations in general.